So if you are a mom, I just want to let you know, first off, that you are doing amazing and you are doing the very best you can for your child. Having a new baby is no easy feat and they don't come with a manual. So it's really, really hard to know what's best for them while keeping yourself in mind while you are chronically sleep deprived. Oh, hi, my name is Jensine Casey. I am your sleep BFF and I bring my years of experience as a pediatric sleep consultant and pair it with my degrees in early childhood to bring you the best sleep advice possible that are real life strategies because mom life, right? So we are talking all about how to get you and your baby the best sleep possible because no one thrives when everyone is exhausted. So the first thing that you're going to want to focus on is making sure that you know what's appropriate for your child's age. As a newborn, we don't want you to have the expectation that your child is going to come home and sleep for 12 hours straight through the night without needing a feed because babies don't work that way. And although they don't come with a manual, a lot of families are surprised at how much sleep newborns need, but how broken up that sleep is in relation to our own sleep. So you may know that newborns sleep probably about 13 to 15 hours a day. That is a lot of sleep. So you would think, great, I can sleep during that time. But that sleep is very broken up. It is an hour here, 3 hours here, 1 hour here, 45 minutes here. So there are often not really big, long chunks of time when that sleep is happening. And if it is, it's probably during the day or when you need to get something else done. If you have an older child, if you have dishes to do, if you have errands to run, though that sleep is gonna happen during those times. So yes, we've probably all heard the phrase sleep when the baby sleeps, but that's just not possible because we have other things that we need to do with our lives. So really the first step is just to understand our newborn sleep and what the expectation is. So we can feel good about what we are expecting of our child, and that limits the frustration from feeling like they should be doing more or doing better or sleeping more on our schedule. So I'm gonna put a link to a video below that talks more about newborn schedule, just so I can give you those expectations to, again, help reduce that frustration. The second thing I want you to think about is, what are your goals for your child's sleep? What is your goal for each and every day? When I had my oldest son, I had one thing that I planned to do every day. And it was just one thing that I was gonna focus on. It was to put the laundry into the washing machine and turn it on. It was to take the dishes out of the dishwasher. That was it. If I got really fancy one day and I was able to put the laundry into the washing machine, turn it on, put that wet laundry into the dryer, turn it on, done. Like magic happened because I felt so accomplished just from that one goal. So we're gonna have one goal per day of what you want. And that goal could be around your child's sleep. It could be around something around the house. It could be around, I want to do tummy time 2 times tomorrow. That's it. So really just break your day down and decide what your goals are around anything. Maybe your child is a little bit older and you're watching this and you don't have a newborn anymore. What are your goals around your child's sleep? Do you want them to have 1 feed overnight? Do you want to bring them down from 5 feeds to 2 feeds? So really just being realistic about what you want from them, and then that's how you can know, okay, how to take this next step. Make sure that you give this video a like and you comment below. Let me know kind of what your expectations have been around your child's sleep. Do you feel like you had really different expectations that maybe weren't appropriate for their age? And if you did, please don't feel any shame or anything around that. It is very, very common in our sleep deprived state to just beg our child to just do better or do more because we really need that sleep to be able to thrive and be the best parents that we can be ourselves. Also, in the description, there are lots of free resources. So I have a guide for the first 6 weeks with your newborn. I have a guide for 4 to 12 month bedtime. So if those are areas that you're struggling with, make sure that you go to the description, click those links, and it will get sent directly to your inbox. But stick around because I'm going to give you the best tip that people kind of gave me, but I didn't really follow. So the best one was to schedule in a break. You need to do that because as your baby's sleep is changing and sporadic, you need to know that you will still have the opportunity to sleep. So how can you make that happen during your day? Do you need to hire a night nurse or an overnight doula to be able to come and be with your child specific nights during the week so that you can get the restorative sleep that you need? Can you have a family member come during the day and watch the baby so you can sneak a nap in? Can you arrange it so your spouse comes home from work and they kind of take a shift while you can get some rest? There really are multiple ways to do it, but really just ensuring that you are taking care of you is so essential at any age, no matter how old your child is. My children are no longer newborns. At the time of this filming, they are 2, 4, and 6 years old, and I still need a break. I still need a chance to just be me and come up to our bedroom and just sit and read a book or just sit and drink some tea and just take some time for myself so that when I come back, I can be the best mom that I can be for them. So taking a break is really, really essential. And if you don't follow any other advice that you've ever heard about motherhood or anything, that is gonna be the piece that I want you to follow. So one of the biggest things that parents worry about around their child's sleep is often they're crying. They don't want them to cry at all and in relation to any sleep situation. So for naps, for bedtime, and that often, again, leads to some hard expectations where we never want our child to make any noise, but we also do want them to make noise at other times during the day to communicate what they need. So really, if you shift your thinking around that crying during a sleep situation to how you think about crying in any other situation, it's really just for them to be able to communicate what they need. So if you have any worries about your child crying around sleep, then you're going to want to visit the pinned video in my channel. It is going to walk you all through how to identify the cries that your child is crying and frame it so you understand from a communication standpoint what those cries are trying to say and not put our adult emotions on that crying. So that is a really great video if you have ever had any anxiety around your child crying in a sleep situation or not. So go visit that video and I will see you over there.